So this is an introductory overview kind of a talk, and it tells you the background for this project, what we are doing, why we are doing this, and so on. So I'm going to talk about FOSSI and Spoken Tutorial projects. FOSSI logo is here, Spoken Tutorial logo is here. This is IIT Bombay logo. Okay, schedule, we will come to that later, but we will start at 10 o'clock every day and finish at 5 o'clock. There are 3 days, today, tomorrow, day after tomorrow. And there will be a 1 hour lunch break at 1 o'clock our time. We promote FLOSS. FLOSS stands for Free Stroke Liber and Open Source Software. Why are we promoting FLOSS? Because we can use it legally and free of cost. It comes with license such as BSD and GPL. Using open source software allows learners to become better programmers. It is free of cost to the industry also. So when we train our students with this software, FLOSS, they can use them in industry also. Whereas commercial software is often very expensive to industry, sometimes even 100 times. Then those software are not available in the industry. So students, even if they are well-trained in that software, cannot use them. So our students become industry ready. It is ideal during pandemic, wherein students are at different locations. Each one can download their own copy of the software and use it. We promote FLOSS through FOSSI, which is a free and open source software for education. That's a logo. And then Spoken Tutorial, logo of Spoken Tutorial is here. What is a Spoken Tutorial? It's a 10 minute long audio video tutorial. It is for ICT training at a global scale to improve the employment potential of students. What are the features of Spoken Tutorials? These are created for self-learning, guaranteed for self-learning. I will explain this shortly. These are dubbed into our 22 languages. These are usable offline without internet, available free of cost, released under CC BY-SA, CC BY-SA license, accessible without login. You don't even have to log into our website. And so this CC stands for Creative Commons. Okay. And only FLOSS covered. We don't cover any commercial software at all under Spoken Tutorial. As a result, you can be assured that whatever is covered, whatever you see in the tutorial will be available to you for use. These are designed for self-learning through novice check of the underlying script. What is that? This is how we design our tutorials. We write a script so that we can use that script to record, but we don't record it immediately. We ask the question, can a beginner understand? Because very often it is the expert who creates the script, but we want the beginner to be able to understand it. Most of the time, the answer is no. A beginner cannot understand. So we say, improve the script. We tell them, send the script back and say, please improve it. And it goes on in this loop many times. But finally, it comes out most of the time and the beginner can understand. We record the tutorial with that. That tutorial is Spoken Tutorial. I'm going to show you a sample.
Welcome to the Spoken Tutorial on Embedding Mathematics in XFIG.
Okay, and then we dub the spoken part into India's 22 official languages.
C++ mein constructors aur destructors ke Spoken Tutorial mein aapka swagat hai.
So this is in Hindi.
Spoken Tutorial cha creating basic Marathi. Content varil.
Tamil.
Flow sheeting ke harimugam kurita Spoken Tutorial ke nal varavu.
নমস্কার বন্ধুগণ আপনাদের স্বাগত জানাই আমাদের
বেঙ্গালি
জাভা ইত্যাস্মিন অঙ্কগণিতীয় প্রক্রিয়ায়াহ পাঠম প্রতি স্বাগতম
The dubbed audio helps people not fluent in English. The video in English helps retain employment opportunities. We come up with simple language so that dubbing becomes easy. It is also helpful to the target audience because we are targeting at the bottom of the pyramid. It should be accessible to everybody. And sometimes they have difficulty in learning and simple language helps them. It is helpful to people in neighboring countries because we have many common languages. We have sample dubbing in many international languages also.
Spoken tutorial dar e-card animation by istifade az sinfe khosh amadid.
Spoken tutorial for token Chongsi Vasikoko.
Bienvenido al tutorial hablado de LibreOffice Writer, teclado y formateo básico de texto.
Okay, so I have a question. Now that we have a lot of people from Mexico, will Mexico be interested in dubbing in Spanish? All our tutorials are available. Timed script is available for all tutorials. We have the script with the timing. Okay, that is very useful. We can record the audio and stitch it with video. It's an extremely easy process. We have some of the spoken tutorial team members also here. Let me introduce them. Is Nancy here? Okay, is Sakina there? Oh, I forgot to share the... Priyam, can you share the link for today's video with Nancy and Sakina?
Yes, sir, I'll do. I'll do it right
away. I will introduce them at the end of my talk, and then you can say hello to them. Okay, so let me go back to the presentation. We have more than 1,000 tutorials in English. We have 10,000 dubbed tutorials into 22 plus languages. Okay, I will answer the questions, doubts later. And then access to internet is not required because you will see that you will be using offline version. I'm going to demonstrate that a little later. We use offline version, as I mentioned. Using this offline version, we conducted this workshop for 250 people. They're all college teachers. This workshop was on LaTeX. We have 250 people. And then, in fact, why 250? We can even conduct training for 1,000 people in one go. And because it is recording, because it is you're learning from tutorial, you can learn at your own pace. You can rewind, listen to it. Those of you who understand the subject can go a little faster. You might even skip some tutorials and so on. So there are many benefits. So we can do it even for 1,000 people. Lately, Myanmar is in news. There is a coup with the army taking over. We conducted a workshop in Myanmar 3 years ago. And in fact, at that time, even internet, even electricity was not there. Forget about internet. In fact, we waited for electricity to come to take this photograph. And you can see that all of them are using laptop. Nobody uses desktop because at that time, they didn't have reliable electricity connection. Are the design decisions useful? We have trained 6 million students in the past 7 to 8 years. And we have also trained 200,000 teachers. Direct web page learners is additional. There are many people who come to our website because we don't have login. We don't know who they are, but they come and take our material. No registration login is required. Our approach helps different types of audience. We have introductory topics, office, LibreOffice, programming, advanced programming. For simulation, DWSim is the focus of this workshop. OpenModelica, I'll talk about a little later. OpenFOAM workshop is there shortly. I think it is there 2 weeks from now. And then Scilab workshop, that may be about 3 weeks time. Next week, we have a Chem Collective workshop. For graphic artists, these are amazing. This Blender was used to create some parts of Spider-Man 2. Then we have Synfig, Inkscape, GIMP. A school level, K-12 to school level software is also covered here. We have 75 different courses, and this number is increasing. We conduct affordable workshops and certificates in case a college wants to spread it. I mean, all the material is available free of cost, but in case colleges want to use this and give certificates to their students, why the certificates are important is we actually conduct job fair also for people who do well in our online tests. Almost unlimited number of certificates. training and online tests conducted in the college. Students don't have to go anywhere, and invigilated by college teachers. And the college teachers, the invigilator's name appears on the certificate. And this is available at a very affordable price, less than $1 per certificate. We have more than 1,000 colleges benefited by this. As I told you, we have already trained a large number of students using this method. Okay, now I'm going to talk to you about constructing pyramids of excellence using spoken tutorials, using FOSI. Okay. So for spoken tutorials, I already told you this is the method that we created for training at a global scale. Now FOSI is the one that promotes open source software, free libre and open source software. FOSI uses spoken tutorial to build other layers of the pyramid. So let me just go through it quickly. So pyramid, we are going to construct layer by layer. This is the bottommost layer. We say train lots of people through spoken tutorial. Now through FOSI, we construct other layers. FOSI promotes Scilab. We promote Scilab in the place of MATLAB and Xcos in the place of Simulink. Here is Xcos on cloud, for example. Python is something we promote in a big way. We promote OpenFOAM in the place of Fluent. So for all of you who are interested in computational fluid dynamics, OpenFOAM is an amazing software. It is used in BARC, our nuclear establishment. It is used in ISRO, our space establishment. It is used in DRDO, our defense labs. That is because OpenFOAM is extremely useful, powerful, and it is also open source software. These are some of the pictures, some of the graphics created by OpenFOAM. Cut section, streamlines over rear view wing. We also have some companies that are working with some of our colleagues in mechanical engineering for the design of their fans, for example, so that they will have the nice design for streamline flow. And then we promote R in a big way in the place of SPSS. We promote eSIM, electronic circuit design software, and that's a replacement for OrCAD, PSPICE, LTSPICE, and so on. This is our logo, we created it. Here is a schematic of a circuit, mixed signal simulation circuit created in eSIM. We promote through DWSim and OpenModelica chemical process flow sheeting. These are a replacement for Aspen Plus, ChemCAD, SimSci, Pro2, and so on. The main focus of the current workshop is DWSim, although I will talk about OpenModelica for about half an hour. I think it is tomorrow I'll give a talk. This is the logo of DWSim. At this point, I would like to acknowledge Daniel Wagner, the creator of DWSim. He's a Brazilian. And he's a good friend. In fact, it's an amazing software, DWSim, that he has created and released to the whole public. We are very happy that we are in a position to promote. You will see later in this workshop, during all 3 days, you will see how we are promoting, how students from various parts of the world are participating in our promotion. As a result, large number of trained people on DWSim are available in case any company wants to recruit. If any company wants to, you know, take some people as interns, for example, I can point you to good people, students who are well versed in DWSim, for example. So it's an amazing software, and I request you to take this workshop seriously. Just follow exactly what we are saying, the method that we are suggesting in this workshop. As I told you, this workshop, this method we are going to follow in this workshop is scalable. Even 1,000 people can be trained without quality dilution. That is why we have chosen this method. Anyway, I'll come back to that. We promote OpenModelica and OpenIPSL. This is for power system simulation. For graphics and animation, we promote GIMP, Inkscape, Scribus. Scribus is a software, open source software for PageMaker and so on. As I told you, Blender, we already told you, Synfig Studio. We promote QGIS. In fact, recently we conducted a mapathon wherein we mapped the entire country of India. 10,000 students participated from various parts of India using the maps provided by ISRO. And Linux is promoted in the place of Windows. We promote hardware also. OpenPLC is something that we designed. We promote chemistry software. FOSSI conducts online workshops to train students on contribution. For example, this is one such workshop. Students from across India created code. They wrote code to 75,000 solved example problems from standard textbooks. Okay, this is something that we can give a demo of later in case anybody is interested in Scilab. We'll do that later. DWSim, we have, I have written 175 chemical flow sheet, but I think we have more than that, close to 200. We have about 500 electronic circuits in eSim. Open form, 100 case studies, etc. And all of these are created by crowd, that is people from across the world, mostly across India, but lately quite a few people from overseas, especially in DWSim. And what is more, all of these are available under Creative Commons license, that is open source, open educational resource, available free of cost to all of you. All of you can download and use them. People from companies, you may find some of your processes already simulated in the chemical flow sheets, flow sheeting project. Feel free to download and experiment with them. We have a second layer of, so that is the second layer of pyramid. First layer, train lots of people through spoken tutorial. Then second layer through textbook companions, flow sheets, circuits, case studies. So that means a smaller number of people go to the second layer. People who do some extra work, who demonstrate their capability on their own interest. They come on their own and they, because the university, the college doesn't require that, but they still come and do this because they want to do well in life. They want to learn, they want to demonstrate, they want to help other people. Okay, they go to the second layer. Next layer of the pyramid, we have FOSSI Fellowship. We have hackathons. FOSSI Fellows created eSIM on cloud. FOSSI Fellows created Arduino on cloud, for example. Open Modelica chemical engineering simulator front end was created. We even conducted a Scilab toolbox hackathon. 8 Scilab toolboxes were created.
FOSSI IIT Bombay presents online Synfig Studio 2D animation hackathon.
So we even conducted an animation hackathon. So people who contribute, who join here, they belong to a smaller set, a subset of this, and they work even more. They go to the next level. So this way, we go on selecting people to the next and next levels of the pyramid. Then research, building simulators, etc., major projects, entrepreneurship. So you can see that the pyramid is getting slowly constructed. Students at the top of the pyramid can be placed anywhere in the world. They are so good, they can be placed anywhere in the world. And mind you, all of them start with open source software. All of them start with something, everything is freely available, and that's how they start. Students at the top of the pyramid can be placed anywhere. Seeing this, those at lower levels will aim higher and achieve. Everybody will say, well, if I had done a little more work, I would have gone to the next level. And everybody would say that. As they say that, you see that the whole pyramid gets lifted. By the way, there is, visited pyramids in Mexico City. It's away from Mexico City. I think it's about 30-40 kilometers away from Mexico City. Those are ancient, I think 1,000, 2,000 years old. Really, I'm reminded of those pyramids when I see this word pyramid, okay? Whole pyramid gets lifted. We need thousands of such pyramids for our countries. We need DWSim, OpenModelica, OpenFOAM, every one of them. Whatever problem you're looking at, whatever vertical you're looking at, we need it for arts, we need it for chemistry, we need it for animation, and so on and so forth. Every one of them, we need to construct such a pyramid. Take everybody, train them, allow them to express themselves, excel, and keep going up. Okay, that's when our countries will become developed countries. To conclude, FLOSS is a great concept. It's ideal for training at a global scale, promoted by FOSSI at ST. And what is FLOSS? Free liber. Liber means freedom. When I say free, people may think it is free of cost. It is not just the free of cost, it's freedom. That's what is indicated by the letter L. And open source software. It's a great concept. It's ideal for training at a global scale. It is promoted by FOSSI and Spoken Tutorial projects to construct pyramids of excellence. We are funded by the National Mission on Education through ICT, Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya National Mission on Teachers and Teaching. Both are initiatives of the Ministry of Education, Government of India. So here I finish the first part of my presentation. I have one more presentation to tell you how this workshop will be conducted. But let me stop sharing and see if there are any questions. I think there are some questions in the chat. Let me just check. We have people who introduce themselves through this. This is fine. Yeah, Kunjan Patel, no problem. You can connect through laptop, but laptop is required. Just for listening to somebody, mobile phones are okay. But here you have to practice DWSim. So you should get hold of a laptop or a desktop. If you don't speak, it is okay.
Sir, I've opened my office PC parallelly so that if in case we practice something on the software, then I can practice over there and in the laptop as well.
Absolutely, no problem. We have no problem. We have no problem as long as your company has no problem.
Yeah, fine.
Absolutely, because it's illegal.
Correct.
We are not doing anything illegal. You can copy it. Mm-hmm. Once again, thanks to Daniel Wagner. That it is available free of cost. Please take it, use it. And he's an expert. In case your company needs an expert consultant, contact Daniel Wagner. Okay.
Yeah, sir. Actually, the main concern was that if I listen through my laptop on one side and on the other side, through my office PC, I can work. So, parallelly, both things
no problem.
Can go on. Yeah.
Welcome.
Yeah, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, we have a comment offer from Mexico, Miguel, Professor Miguel saying related to dubbing. Yes, in Mexico, we are interested. So let me just show you what needs to be done now that you are said. Are there any other questions? We can come back to this. Let me just go to Spoken Tutorial webpage. Before that, of course, I have to share my screen. So you can see that one doesn't have to log in here to access this information. You can see a lot of topics are there, right? You can see a lot of topics are there. And in fact, if you want to know what to watch, there are too many things happening. So one can even go to, spokentutorial.in. If you go to spoken-tutorial.in, he's our former president, beloved president, who said that we must use open source software. About our project, all the tutorials that we cover here, DWSim, for example, is here. School level software is here. Health and nutrition is here. Forum, which we will be using in a big way, is here. Some of the other things are here. But anyway, let's go to, let me click here. It comes here. Looks like we are supposed to be telling, let me just see schools. If I click schools, yeah, it tells you what are the different things. We need to do a similar thing for the Spoken Tutorial main page also. For example, what are the different topics? Basic IT skills, animation and graphics, programming and languages, programming languages, information technology, geography, science, biology. So these are what are available. Okay, and then how do I go there from here? Okay, so that's a bummer. Learn more. Is Nancy there?
Yes, sir, I'm here.
So how do I go to that page?
No, so that web page is not yet available, sir.
No, you have to give just a link from, oh, I see, that is not there, is it? Okay.
Yeah, for schools, we have not yet enabled that link yet.
Okay, for this, you want to put a similar page for the Spoken Tutorial main page also.
Okay, okay.
Only the main things, yeah? And then
yes.
People can go from here. From that page, you should go to the main page.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so let me just go back to the page. Huh. So there are various topics are there. Now I wanted to spend a little bit of time on Spanish dubbing. We had a student from New York with us for 6 months, and his mother is a Mexican. So he spoke fluent American and fluent Mexican. So we wanted him to record this for us. I think this is what one of these I demonstrated. Let me just see inserting pictures and okay. You can see the script here. Inserting images. Let me just play this and then show that to you.
Bienvenido al tutorial hablado sobre LibreOffice Writer, inserting images. En este tutorial aprenderemos lo siguiente. Insertar un archivo de imagen en un documento. Insertar tablas en Writer.
Okay, so you got an idea. So this script has to be written. We give the same thing in English. You have to replace every box with Spanish equivalent. And then speak each sentence, and then create the audio, stitch it with the video. It's extremely simple. And we would even want to know whether Mexican government will be interested, because all the tutorials are available free of cost. And I'm sure our government will be very happy to offer the entire thing to the Mexican government. If you can talk to somebody in your government, they can do that. Even if government is not interested, it doesn't matter. Your university can actually contribute, create it, and roll it out for the whole country. Okay, so that is something that I thought I will explain. Let me just see. Stop sharing. We have Nancy here. Nancy, can you please come on the video? Yeah. So Nancy is the one who leads our Spoken Tutorial content creation team. We also have Sakina. Sakina, are you there?
Yes, sir. I'm here.
Can you come on the video? So Sakina is the one who coordinates the dubbing in various languages. All the languages that you saw were coordinated by Sakina. So Nancy and Sakina are the people who create tutorials, who have implemented these amazing features so that it is useful for conducting such large training programs. Okay, because we have trained, as I told you, 6-7 million students using this method. And certainly this is useful for people in Mexico as well. Okay, there is Sakina. Sakina, you want to say hello?
Hello, everybody.
Okay, you will help people dub it into Spanish.
Of course, I'll be more than happy to do that.
Okay, so there you are, Miguel. We'll be happy to have your students contribute, and our team will be happy to conduct a workshop on how to do the dubbing. Whoever is interested can come, and then not only in chemical engineering, but in every field, okay? And we'll be happy to do that for you later on, okay? We'll be in touch with you for that. Okay, thank you, Nancy, Sakina. All right, now let me go back to the second, yeah, Miguel, you want to say something? You have a question for Sakina or Nancy?
No, Professor. Thank you very much.
Okay. So we'll be very happy to help you because we have a lot of experience. We have dubbed 10,000 tutorials in various languages. And so we have created the tutorials for easy dubbing because in India, we have 22 languages. So we wanted to come up with a method suitable for dubbing in every one of them. Okay. So Spanish is one of the languages. So we'll be delighted to do the dubbing, help you do the dubbing. Dubbing has to be done by you, but we are ready to provide all the support required for that. Just imagine what this will do. It will give the high quality videos, all high quality videos to all students in Mexico, whether they are in engineering, sciences, arts, graphics, animation, computer science, whatever it is, all the thing we have created will be available, you know, free of cost, because these are already released under Creative Commons license. So these are available. Just under dubbing is a very small fraction of the total effort, because the novice check of the script, that that takes a lot of effort. We spend a lot of time to create a original because we do a lot of validation to be suitable for self-learning. Once it is validated, same high quality material is available to every language with a very simple audio dubbing. Okay. And not only that, students who want to improve their English can also improve. You know, that is something that people in Mexico would want to improve their English. Listen to the Spanish version first, understand the subject, listen to the same topic in English, then their English will improve. It is going to be very helpful to them. I'm sure that a lot of people will be interested in that. Okay, so we will get back to you, to Miguel and other professors, and of course, all the students who are here. Yeah, you're working a PhD thesis related to engineering education with DWCM. Fantastic. In fact, I'm going to show some papers then that we have published, because you will see that I'm a chair professor in education. Okay, I'm a chemical engineer, but
Doctor, I send you in the weekend.
Yeah. Sorry, Rafael. Yeah, sorry. I thought it was Miguel. Okay.
Don't worry. Thank you, Doctor.
Yeah, yeah. Really delighted to know that you are doing a PhD in education, engineering education, DWCM. It's a fantastic topic, fantastic area, and extremely useful to students.
I'm working in my PhD thesis is in engineering.
Absolutely.
I would like to write in education.
Yes. Yes, it's a great topic. It's a great subject. Yeah.